Hi, I'm Ameya from Techtree.com, and today we have for you the Lava Xtron Plus tablet. Now, a while ago, we had reviewed its predecessor, the Lava Xtron, and we had recommended a few changes, or rather a few add-ons. Now, Lava supposedly has taken our feedback into consideration and has come up with the Xtron Plus. Let's see if they manage to plug all the holes. For starters, this tablet looks exactly like its predecessors with the metallic body and the sturdy construction. Also, this comes with a 7-inch display with a 1024x600 resolution, again, same as the earlier Xtron. But unfortunately, this screen is not the same that they've used in the earlier design. This one is pretty washed out, and more importantly, the view angles are pretty bad. One simple reason for that is this is not an IPS display and the effects are showing. Under the hood, this one has a 1.5 GHz dual core processor, 1 GB of RAM and 8 GB of internal storage, which you can expand further using the microSD card slot. On the software front, it comes with the latest Android Jelly Bean 4.2 and the interface is pretty stock, which means if you've used any Android device before, you should be able to adapt to this pretty quickly. The hardware does translate into good performance as we tried running a lot of apps on this device and most of them ran pretty smooth. On the gaming front, the tablet comes with a Mali 400MP GPU, which is good for gaming as far as entry-level or mid-level games are concerned. We tried running Angry Birds Star Wars and of course Temple Run 2 on this device and they ran pretty smooth. You might have guessed that the plus in the name Xtron Plus denotes that this device has something extra over its predecessors. And there are two things. One is the rear camera, which is a 2-megapixel camera, and the other one is the HDMI port. Now the camera completely disappoints. Though it's present, it's barely usable because the photo quality is really, really bad. As far as the HDMI port is concerned, the output is fabulous. And this device can run HD videos pretty smoothly. So all you need to do is use a micro HDMI to HDMI cable, connect it to any HD TV and just play it straight out of this device onto the TV. As far as the battery life of this device is concerned, it's around 4 to 5 hours, which is pretty average for most tablets with 7-inch screens. But one issue that we have here and what we had with its predecessor as well are the charging times. It takes around 5 to 6 hours to charge fully, and which is not at all impressive. And to put things into perspective, it takes more time to charge than the amount of battery power that it can provide to this tablet. Now let's quickly look back at the pros and the cons of this device. What goes in favor of this tablet is basically its sturdy construction and more importantly a good set of processing hardware and memory. Also, the HDMI port is quite handy and useful. What goes against it is its very, very disappointing screen and camera, and of course, the charging times. Other than that, it's a pretty decent tablet, but we would say if the HDMI port is not so important to you, you might as well go for the predecessor, which is 500 rupees cheaper. Talking about the price, this one comes for around 7,000 rupees, and the predecessor, as I mentioned, was for 6,500 rupees. So taking its price into consideration, its performance and also the features that it brings to the table, we rate it at 3.5 out of 5 stars. So that's it for now. For more about gadgets and the latest in the tech space, keep watching this channel or even better, subscribe to it.